Again, at this point in time, it's just... well, the news that we're getting at this hour has got to do with the aircraft accident again. The Investigation Bureau has recovered a digital flight data recorder and the cockpit voice recorder, importantly, from this aircraft. These are going to be brought to Delhi for further investigation, is what we know. So finally, there's been recovery of the cockpit voice recorder and the black box. And Zeba, you were just mentioning this is going to obviously help in indicating what really happened minutes before this crash and what really went wrong. This is going to be brought to Delhi for further investigations. Tell us more, Zeba.
Well, certainly, as far as the investigation is concerned, this is where it's headed now. It is being considered a very, very serious incident. It goes without saying that it has caused a major tragedy. The pictures, the visuals from the crash site itself tell us what really transpired, what happened. That the aircraft, essentially, which is a Boeing 737 aircraft, a big aircraft, which split into two pieces, the fuselage completely ripped open. So now, at the moment, all the senior officials are in Kozhikode. We have a meeting that is currently underway here at Rajiv Gandhi Bhavan, a DGCA meeting. They're coordinating all the efforts between Kerala and Delhi. The senior officials of the DGCA, including the DGCA director, the Minister of Civil Aviation, Hardeep Singh Puri, they're all headed to Kozhikode. Some of them have already reached there. The Air India Express CEO, Air India CMD, all the top officials are at the moment on the ground. They are assessing the situation and also leading the investigation. Remember, the Air Accident Investigation Bureau are the ones who are leading the probe. This is being supervised directly by the Civil Aviation Minister at the moment and the DGCA as well.
That's right. You know, Zeba, the other question that has now risen is about the kind of warnings that were given to rectify the kind of problems that this particular runway was facing. Though many say that let's not blame the runway completely, but there were concerns, and I think the precautions, the kind of steps that were asked to be taken, I think that particular suggestion was ignored.
Well, there are some serious questions that certainly do arise now. In 2019, DGCA issued a show-cause notice to this very airport, and there were many red flags that were raised. Now, specifically about runway 10, which is this particular runway, there were two red flags that were raised by DGCA. One of excessive rubber deposited on the at the edge of the runway, and the other was the digital monitor, the digital wind equipment not functioning. So these are the two things that we saw in that show-cause notice that specifically talked about this runway. It remains to be seen whether we will get some clarity as to whether all these issues were resolved. Because if they weren't, then are these red flags related to yesterday's incident? Because if it is the same airport which had so many red flags that were raised by the Director General of Civil Aviation, were these errors rectified by the airport in time, or is that in any way linked to the tragedy that we saw happened yesterday? These are certainly